Honestly, it gets harder to find people to work tonight every year.
What do you expect? It's New Year's Eve.
For everybody but us, that is.
Oh, poor Amy. Some unfeeling supervisor put you on the duty list for tonight.
Both of us, but only until 11.
Oh, half the evening's over by then.
Oh, I'm sure that somehow you two will make up for it. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, now, as I dimly recall, Doctor, this is what they promised us back in med school. Two gorgeous creatures with nothing on their mind but fun and games.
Yes, I think I recall the name of the course, Doctor. Fun and Games 102.
102, Fun and Games, yes.
Well, you can stop your Fun and Games 102. We're stuck on duty tonight.
What?
But only until 11.
Oh, 11 o'clock is still the beginning of the evening, the first part.
Plenty of time to get to Tiffany's costume party. You're going, yes?
I don't know. You tell us, are we?
Like a girl that gets to the point. Yes, you're going, and you're going with us.
Okay.
We'll meet you at Tiffany's.
Okay.
Eagerly?
Yeah, don't forget, you have to wave, let us know, because everyone's going to be in costume, okay?
Okay.
Okay, yeah. I might end up with the wrong girls. Wouldn't want to do that.
Oh, no, that would be a tragedy of major proportions.
Tragedy of major proportions. Fantastic. Listen, now that we've got dates, what are we going to wear?
Well, we might go disguised as doctors.
Doctors?
Well, Amy, you know something? I haven't got a costume. Have you?
No, I haven't. But I do know what we could do about that.
Don't say we can dress as nurses.
No, actually, I was going to be more original than that. I think I will call a costume rental company and see what they've got.
Darling, I'm telling you what, if you don't have it right, I'm going to have your Google for it. I'm telling you, come here, quick. Could you please put this, hang this up right over here across that little thing? Thank you, very kindly. Oh, darling. Who is it? Come in.
Baby, darling. Should I be wearing a diaper?
No.
Oh, I'm so glad that you came, darling. How was your flight, man?
Oh, it was rather strange. Really strange.
Yes.
Oh, I'm sort of falling apart.
So darling.
Laura Spencer caught the same flight. Thank you.
Oh, yeah?
Just throw it here. And, Tiff, is that girl playing with a full deck?
Why do you ask that?
Well, it was weird, actually. Laura's convinced that some man is following her, and then when we landed, Luke wasn't there to meet her at the airport, and she just went to pieces. She got all upset.
Yeah, I know.
Well, anyway, you know, we shared a cab. She dropped me off here, and she went on to the boat. What do you mean, you know?
I mean, I know why Luke wasn't there. It was, seems that he's disappeared, kind of.
Well, I don't get it. How does someone kind of disappear?
Nobody knows. He's just missing. And poor Robert has been up all night long. He is worried sick about him.
Yeah. Nothing? Well, are you sure about that? What about the other cab driver, Slick? Okay, yeah, you're alerted and good. Yeah, just keep on looking. The minute you know us anything at all, you call me. You got it? Okay, bye. Rose, it's Robert. Give me some good news. Nothing. Okay, look, I just talked to Slick and he hasn't seen anything either. If Luke should call, I don't need to tell you to tell him to call me. Got it? Fine. Laura.
Robert, where is Luke? He was supposed to meet me at the airport and he never showed up.
We may have a bit of a problem here. I think your husband could have been kidnapped. Look, something's happened, and right at this point, it's the only thing that makes any logical sense. I got half the people we know out looking for him, and by now, somebody should have seen him.
By now? How long has he been gone?
All night.
Oh, no.
Come on, sit down. Look, as I said, I've got Slick, I've got a whole lot of other people we can trust in the waterfront, trying to find him. Now, I'm expecting some good news any minute.
But I still don't understand what happened.
Right. A number of things have happened. Remember that guy who was emphatic that we buy liquor from him?
Yeah, you threw him overboard.
Right, okay. Now, the way I figure this, he's just a stooge for whoever is the head man. Ironically, this guy seems to go under the name of the Mouse and leaves a mouse trap as his calling card.
A mouse trap?
Yeah, but I'll get to that. First, Luke and I had this little go-round with a
tank of propane gas. Now, I figure that the Mouse's men brought this on board, thoughtfully left the tap open. By the time we discovered it was too late and we were out cold.
What?
Yeah, it's a long story. I'll get to it later. Then I discovered this mouse trap here. It was lying on the floor over there. When I came in, I discovered this later. The place had been torn up, signs of a definite struggle, and definitely no Luke.
So you think that this, whoever this guy is, Mouse, or he's the one that kidnapped Luke?
That's a definite possibility, love.
Robert, do you think this could go back? You know, some one of
Frank Smith?
Frank Smith's men. That's
right. Another option. I don't know what to think.
I just don't see how this could possibly have happened. Luke has always been able to take care of himself. He can't have just disappeared.
He didn't.
Luke.
Yeah, sure.
Jeff, darling, I'm not sure. I mean, do you really think I should?
Well, you want to match Robert, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
And you said he'll be dressed like a pirate.
Yes, I already bought the costume for him yesterday.
Then trust me. So he'll be a pirate and you'll be his wench.
What's a wench?
You, dear. It's typecasting, believe me.
Oh, good.
Yeah, wench is a pirate's girlfriend. But if Robert suggests you walk the plank, don't do it under any circumstances, okay? You do feel like a wench, don't you? It's exciting.
Actually, you know, all I really feel right now is a little bit worried about Luke. You know, ever since you told me that Laura was felt like somebody was following her?
Yeah, I'm getting a knock.
This whole thing frightens me, you know?
Well, I just think, you know, actually, Tiffany, that Laura, she's just imagining it. I mean, she's not a very sophisticated girl. Just being in the big city made her so jumpy, I made her stay at my place last night.
Oh, Dad, I'm so glad you did.
Well, I didn't mind. She's sweet, of course, but there are... It's not working. Distinct tinges, you know, of the small-town girl around the edges. Last night, I was sure she'd suggest we put on our jammies and make fudge.
Excuse
all I need.
Hello? Oh, Robert, thank heavens. They found Luke.
Oh.
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's okay, Tiff. Yeah, we'll be over later. You can check him out for yourself. Bye-bye.
Hi. So, I was down on the dock, waiting to meet you. Thank you, baby. When I saw the mouse.
Was he here on the ship?
Mm-hmm. When I saw him come on board, I decided to just wait there until he came off.
Yeah, that's when he left his calling card. Nice touch, don't you think?
Isn't that horrible?
Well, go on now. Well, you're on the dock. What happened then?
As soon as he got in his car, took off, I hitched a ride on his back bump.
Fun?
Oh, delightful, just like Disneyland. Careening around all the corners down on the waterfront, we ended up in some big warehouse.
And you were still on the bumper?
Yeah, by some miracle. So once the car stopped, I just shimmied under it. That's when I saw the mouse and a bunch of his little rat friends get out. They closed the gate behind them, locking me inside, I might add.
You mean you've been inside an empty warehouse all night?
Yeah, that's right. I was lucky some character came along and unlocked the door this morning, but, anyway, the point is it's not an empty warehouse.
Really?
Yeah. Had a little look around. I didn't really get an accurate count, but I would say there are probably 600 cases of booze in there.
You hit the mother load.
You got it. Ready and waiting, partner.
Luke, you're confusing me. I don't understand.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. Look, I'm going to have to pass any further explanations. Oh, do you realize I've been up half the night cultivating gray hair about you?
I was hoping you would be.
So if you'll pardon me, I'm going home to get some well-earned sleep. Tiffany has this whimsical idea about my portraying a pirate tonight. Right now, I couldn't board the Staten Island ferry. See you two later.
Start at the beginning, I'll tell you the whole thing, but do me a favor first, will you? Give me one big, juicy hug.
Luke, I was so worried about you. I'm just glad that you're
here. Anybody need a costume for tonight?
We both do, and Amy and I are on duty until 11.
Ah, you're all set, I hope.
Oh, I'm going to be a knockout.
Good, because so am I. If there's a prize, Jesse, I'll split it with you.
That's very kind of you.
You remember the last costume party we went to?
Oh, indeed I do. You was a boa constrictor, and I had sore ribs for about a month.
Jesse's going to
going with Dan. I thought he was taking Ruby.
Well, he was, but she's not feeling well at all, and she's going to stay home all night.
Really?
Yeah.
She doesn't sound like Ruby.
She didn't sound too good when I talked to her on the phone.
Huh.
Yeah.
I think maybe I'm going to talk Ruby into a full checkup. You know, she had that sudden pain about a month or so ago, and now this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's not her. That concerns me.
Main desk, Miss Vining.
Stop a little. No.
Yeah, Dr. Weber is right here. Hold on a second. It's for you.
Yeah.
And he's tall, dark, and handsome.
Oh, anybody I married recently?
Hello.
Hi, honey.
Here.
Oh. Yeah. Oh. No, you did not hear a whimper. No, there's absolutely no problem. I'll just go home and as soon as you get her stable, then you come along.
Guys, what's so
of course I'm going to wait. You're the only date of God.
I know.
Who cares? I love you. Bye.
I've got a problem.
Oh, well, join the club. Amy and I don't have costumes, and we have to work until 11.
Well, now it's your turn to join my club. I haven't got one either, and I'm on duty till 11.
Have you thought of going as the three witches from Macbeth?
Not funny. Look, don't worry. I'm going to get us costumes. I'll get you one, too. I refuse to miss this party tonight. Laura's going to be there, isn't she? I mean, she did get back from New York, all right?
Yeah, I'm sure she did.
What's she going to wear, do you know?
I haven't the foggiest idea. Maybe now that she's Miss Star Eyes, she'll wear her costume from the commercials.
I'm sorry, baby. I'm going on and on about me and this stupid mouse character and everything. Tell me about you. How did it go?
No, look, I'll tell you all about me later. I'm worried about you, Luke. I want to know who this mouse person is. I mean, is he connected with Frank Smith?
Oh, well, no. You know as well as I do. Smith is in the joint.
Yeah, I know that. But you told me once before that Smith was powerful enough that even if he were behind bars, he could still be running his rackets.
Yeah, that's possible, but, I mean, it probably has nothing to do with Smith. Mouse has nothing to do with him. Forget it. Come on.
Are you sure of that?
I want you to stop worrying about me, okay? Please, I promise.
I'll try.
Great. Now, tell me about the big city.
Well, it was really a lot of fun.
Yeah?
Actually, it was magnificent.
Yeah.
They had about 20 people there, and they were all working to make me look beautiful.
What? They're wasting money. They don't need 20 people. You're always beautiful.
Oh, well, thank you, but this is different. I mean, like my hair. They use these electric fans on it, so no matter which way I turn my head, my hair always looks teased.
Teased?
Well, yeah, you know, it's kind of sexy.
You mean like now? It's really sexy now. I mean, like...
No. It was a lot of hard work, though, too. I mean, they only gave me about 10 minutes for lunch, and then they start the whole thing over again. But I did a good job, if I do say so myself. And Delphina thought so, too.
Delphina, was she there?
Yeah. They hired her to do my wardrobe. And as a matter of fact, I stayed with her the last night that I was there.
I thought you had a hotel room in your contract.
Oh, I do. Of course I do. It's just... Well, I was just, kind of nervous. The last night, I didn't want to be alone.
All right, now I know you real well. Tell me the truth. What were you nervous about? What?
I tried to tell you on the telephone, Luke. It's that guy. I know there's a guy following me. In the studio. I lay down on the couch for a little while, and I guess I fell asleep. And then I woke up and I opened my eyes and I saw him standing right over me, staring at me.
In the studio?
Yeah, right there in the studio. And then before I could even sit up, he was gone. I couldn't find him.
Wait a minute. You said there were about 20 people in that studio. Didn't anybody else see him?
No, they didn't. They really didn't know what I was talking about.
Look, honey, I think that the point is that you were probably...
I know. You're going to say the same thing that Delphina said. That I fell asleep on the couch and I dreamed the whole thing, right?
Well, it's possible, especially if there were 20 people there and nobody else saw him.
Luke, I think I saw him again.
When?
Today.
What, you mean here in Port Charles?
No, on the airplane. Luke, I think I'm being followed. I'm scared. The thing is, he's so tall. I could practically draw you a picture of him right now. He's got this this huge ring that looks almost like a third eye. I'm almost positive it's a star sapphire.
Sapphire?
Yeah. See, then when I see him standing over me and staring at me, he takes his hand and he puts it right up here so that the ring is right between his eyes. And he forces me to stare at it. I mean, I really feel compelled to stare at it. And I can't stop, no matter how hard I try.
Yeah?
Yeah. And then as I'm staring at it, I start feeling sleepy. Real, real sleepy. And then I just kind of feel like I'm drifting through space, and I just don't seem to care anymore. You do believe me, don't you? You know that I'm not making this up.
Oh, no, of course I believe you. Of course I believe you. I don't want you to go back to New York.
Luke, I have to go back to New York. You know I do.
Okay.
And again, it could just be my imagination, I suppose. I mean, I could have dreamed it. I mean, I saw the guy twice on the plane. Now, that could be a coincidence, because a lot of people commute back and forth from Port Charles to New York, and maybe I just happened to get on the same plane with the same guy twice. I don't know. Could be a coincidence. Do you think? Maybe I just dreamed the whole thing. I'm sorry. It's just it's time to get up at 6 o'clock. It's time to start getting ready for Tiffany's party.
Hi. I fall asleep, huh?
Yeah, you did. I was telling you about that man who's bothering me, and I looked over at you, and right in the middle of the whole thing, you were out like a light.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I broke our marriage vows.
You did?
Mm-hmm. I, Luke Spencer, promise to never fall asleep in the middle of your conversation, Mrs. Spencer. Okay. Want to pick up where we left off?
No. Mm-mm. I would rather just go over to Tiffany's and get her costumes.
Oh, no, wait, baby, wait. No, wait a minute. You were telling me something that I'd like you to... I'm sorry I fell asleep. You were telling me about this guy with some ring, something like that. What is that about? Tell me again.
No, I told you about it, and I'm sorry now, because I've decided that he just happens to be some guy who commutes, you know, from New York to Port Charles a lot, and I happen to get on the same plane with him.
Mm-hmm. But what about this ring? You talked about a ring that spooked you.
Yeah. Well, I also decided that the rest of it was probably just my imagination and that I'm not going to let this guy bother me. Besides, we've got much more important things to think about, tonight especially.
Like what?
Do you realize that this is the first New Year's Eve I've ever spent with the man that I love? That's funny.
No, I don't think that's funny.
No, I meant funny because I said the man that I love. I can't get used to thinking of you as just my husband, you know?
I will never be just your husband.
I know. Well, I'm going to give Tiffany a call. And I'm going to let her know that we're coming to get the costumes, okay?
Okay. I'll be here.
Hello?
Hi, Tim.
Oh, hi. How
mother of the bride. What's in the box? Your lunch?
My costume for tonight.
You mean I'm not doing one for you?
Sorry, I did it myself.
Leslie, darling, do I tell you how to tickle your patients with your ice-cold stethoscope?
Not so far.
Well, then you stick to being a doctor person and let me do your wardrobe.
I'm fair sorry, enough? Delphina. I have had this planned for so long, but I promise you one thing. You're going to love it.
I love nothing. I don't design myself.
You'll like this.
Oh, really? Something sweet and gingham, no doubt. With little bows in your hair so you look like a milkmaid in my clothes.
Oh, very. But that is absolutely all I'm going to say.
That was Ruth and Laura, darling. They're on their way over right now.
Good.
Oh, that reminds me.
Robert, darling, are you awake? Bluebeard, we're running out of pieces of egg, darling. Hurry, hurry. Get up.
Oh, is Rick going to come over now, darling? Is he joining you?
I don't know. It kind of depends on a patient he has in CICU. He might have to do a bypass.
Oh, that's ridiculous. People don't have strange things done to them on New Year's Eve. On the other hand, I remember on New Year's Eve in Beverly Hills.
Do you think he's going to come over here, Dan? Is he going to meet you here?
I don't really know. If he has to go into surgery, this is a pretty long procedure.
Well, why can't I just simply tell the patient to wait until next week?
Because, Delphina, darling, the patient might not last until next week.
Oh.
So it looks as if my sweet husband may be seeing in the new year in an operating room in General Hospital.
Excuse me? Excuse me? I'll have to take my
own room. She's a wench.
Oh, sensational. What are you?
Oh, isn't it obvious, darling? I'm Robert's wench.
I know that. What about the costume? What does it mean?
Well, she isn't complete yet. This goes on top.
Oh, of course. I never met a wench yet who didn't have something coming out of
her. I haven't tried yet.
Oh, you
need
to talk. Tell me how to
find new work.
Most of it was wonderful. I really had no idea that so much work went into making a commercial.
Most of it was wonderful. Did something go wrong?
That's a long story.
Yeah, not a happy one. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Honest, Mom. Listen, can we talk about it later?
Sure.
Hey, Scorp! Come on, kangaroo skin. Get yourself down here. You got company! It isn't time for my entrance. I'm still busting up the place. Oh, sorry about that. Hey, look, would a big tumbler of martinis and taishudu?
All right. Say no more.
Honey, I don't want to put a damper on the party or anything before it starts, but you really got me concerned. What went on in New York?
Mom, I'm trying to put it out of my mind.
Have you been able to?
No. No, I haven't. I can't stop thinking about this man.
What man?
I know it sounds strange, but I really, really feel that I am being followed.
In New York, you mean?
No. Yes, but here, too. I mean, on the plane this morning. The thing is, he's not just following me. He's watching me. That's just got me scared to death.
Okay, now you got me scared. Have you talked to Luke about this?
Yeah, I did.
So what did he say?
He thinks that it might be a big coincidence that I could have seen the guy when I was in Manhattan and he happened to take the same plane home.
Possible. I don't think you should ever be very far from Luke these days.
Well, Mom, I don't want to be, but I have to be. I have to go back to Manhattan to do the photo sessions for the Mistar Eyes.
Okay, take him with you.
Good idea. I'd certainly feel a lot safer if you were there with me.
I think you should tell him that. Definitely.
Okay. Well, I'll talk to him.
Sorry to break up maybe this touching mother and daughter moment, but Laura, I'm absolutely dying to see what I whipped up for you.
I was leaving.
Okay. This is it.
Perfectly all right.
Is this to die?
Woman, it's so crazy.
Would you please come and help me with these caterers, please? I'm having a very hard time.
I speak French. He's Chinese.
Now that I know where... See, now, but what I'm saying is that, like, now that I know where the Mouse's warehouse is, the only thing we need now is a foolproof plan.
Well, it always was a speciale, on this. Now,
that's right.
What do you have in mind, aside from risking our bloody necks?
Well, I'm not real sure, but the warehouse is guarded day and night by two spuds.
Yeah.
I know that because I had to wait for them to change shifts to get out this morning.
Right. Does this remind you of the good old days?
I love it.
So do I. Okay. Right, where were we? Transporting the booty. Right.
Right. How about shaking our booty in the back of Slick's cab?
That's not bad. The back seat together with the trunk should hold quite a bit.
Yeah, there's only one problem with this, because I've been thinking about it. That is, how are we going to unload it? Because we can't drive that cab up next to the boat, so where are we going to unload it?
When in doubt, do the unexpected.
Like what?
All right, listen to this. We get the cab, load it up with the booze, but instead of driving towards the boat, we drive in the other direction.
You're getting hot now.
All right.
You're getting hot.
We select a nice, quiet pier, rent a few rowboats, and then...
We transport the booze from the cab into the boats, and then we
roll it back to the ship. Yeah. Robert, you're thinking real good.
I know.
You haven't lost your touch.
I hope not. Right. Now, we're now in agreement on this. Okay,
right.
Look, it needs a little bit of touching up here, but let's think along those lines.
All right, well, there's one thing that I think we should consider immediately.
What?
What if the mouse decides to pay us a visit before the heist?
Well, there's always that possibility.
Yes, there is. And if he does, we've got to be ready for him. Robert, I learned something when I was in that warehouse last night. He runs a very tight operation. He plays for keeps. He reminds me a lot of my old friends.
Are you trying to dampen my enthusiasm here?
Hey. What happened to your spirit of adventure?
It's still on the island.
Oh, I see.
What about yours?
Mine is here and with you,
yours,
man.
Yours came back with you.
After last night, I'm ready for anything.
All right.
I am ready for it all.
Good, because you're about to get it.
Uh-oh, what is
this? Look what Delphina made for me.
Great, honey. What is it?
Well, it's not a maternity dress, Buster. Look, this is for you, Luke. You're going to be a swami.
I'm going to be a who?
A swami.
How I love you, how I love you.
Dear old swami.
Looks good.
I live in the world.
Oh, I love it, I love it. Oh, you look divine.
How is it?
I don't know.
You like it?
Swamis have curly hair. I wonder. Well, maybe I should add a veil.
Look, it looks
terrific. You look... Oh, you know, a cobra would be a perfect touch. Luke, darling, you don't happen to know any, do you?
Delphina, most of my friends are reptiles. I would like to ask you one question.
Of course, dear heart. If you're worried about your inseam, I always have my scissors handy.
No, actually, I was going to ask you whose ridiculous idea this idiotic costume party was.
No. The more I reflect on you in this outfit, the more it kind of grows on me.
Is that right?
Are you sure you don't know a good palm reading act?
No, but I can turn a mouse into a silk's ear.
Well,
figure that out.
It's near enough. Listen, be serious. We're going to think of a good diversionary tactic to get rid of these guys on the gate. And nothing extreme, like a World War III or a 10-car pilot, but something really inspired.
Yes.
Okay, what's going on here? I know that look. I know it. And you're not going to get into trouble, are you?
Hey, sweetheart. This guy yours here eats trouble for breakfast.
Mm.
And my friend eats it for lunch. Shall we leave?
Yes, why don't we?
Shall I carry
we can go
this
home
stuff?
And please. It's very heavy.
Thank you, dear.
We can, change it home, right?
Great.
Okay.
Be quick. You don't want to miss the fun.
Bye, hon. I'll be back in just a little while.
Come on, okay.
You going home like that?
A bottle or two for me, will you?
Case or two. All right.
They always know me in Port Charles.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Robert, I am worried about Laura. Should I be?
Yes. You know, frankly, I'm concerned, too. Last night at my place, she was a bundle of nerves.
Well, look, that could be just this new job she's taking on.
No. She says somebody's following her.
Yeah, well, I know, but look, let's face it. I mean, New York is paved with more fruitcake than any other place on the face of the earth.
Oh, that I know. And let's face it, soon she'll be famous. I mean, she is now, really, but once the Miss Star Eyes campaign is released, she'll be even more so. And once your face is known, men stare at you wherever you go, I happen to know.
Yeah, but for other reasons. Look, I wouldn't worry about Laura. I spent all that time on the island with her, and I know that girl can take care of herself in any situation.
Something sounds pretty good to me.
Oh.
Yep.
A gorgeous what?
For your information, I happen to be the Virgin Queen.
I wouldn't touch that line with a Sherman tank.
marvelous.
Mother, mother, very good, dear. Stand up straight. No sitting until the party is over. Dressed in fine fine by a Sherman tan. Right, ladies. Swoop and glide, flowers and feet, pelvic thrust, and you'll do it until you get it right.
Oh, Cretan's here. Oh, well,
she got it bigger than you.
Oh, well, drink more of that.
I don't know.
Three mice just
arrived. I know, aren't they cute?
Definitely not cute.
Hi.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, well, you know, like, Delfina told me that I was supposed to be a swami, you know?
Yeah.
But I've always been real fond of Sinbad the Sailor, so uh-huh. I added a couple of touches
uh-huh.
of my own.
I love it. You look terrific. It's great.
You look
you like
great.
It?
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Oh, baby, Happy New Year. I hope you have a good time tonight.
Oh, I hope so, too, Luke. I'll tell you something. Just knowing that you care, that makes me feel so much better about everything.
You know what?
What?
As Lucy Johnson, as Laura Weber, as whatever the hell you are now,
harem
you are
girl.
The harem girl. You're the most beautiful woman I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, what are you scowling about, darling?
I'm worried about the mice.
What?
Look, have you seen Luke here yet? I mean, what's he?
Oh,
yeah.
Hey.
Oh, I see.
Something for all these little...
Oh, no, baby, nothing.
Everybody
ready? Very special.
I'm ready.
Okay.
Okay.
Everybody ready? Ready?
Ready.
My mistake.
I'm sorry. You okay? What happened?
Now it's stuff I ring.
I'm terribly sorry. I seem to have frightened the young lady. Do forgive me.
Do we know him?
We've met, Mr. Spencer. I'm Dr. Martin Lester. As a matter of fact, my wife and I attended your wedding.
You remember Martin, Laura?
Oh. Yeah, of course. Doctor, I'm sorry. My wife mistook you for someone else.
No harm done. Excuse me.
Well, that'll get your heart started. I guess I'm just a little paranoid.
No, you are not paranoid. You're not paranoid. It's New Year's Eve. I'll look like a fool, and so do you. And give me a big kiss, baby, because it's our New Year's Eve.
Happy New Year.